In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, Presbyterian College's basketball team winds down the regular season as we get ready for seeding for the conference tournament. We're going to have a visit with the coach and a visit by a special senior as part of the basketball team. All that and more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, along with Coach Gregg Nibert. I'm Eric Thacker. Thank you for spending part of your Saturday with us. Well, Coach, you made some changes. I know we didn't get the wins in our last two games, and we'll take a look at the highlights here in a moment. But one thing that I really did like is seeing Reggie Dillard all of a sudden being moved to the point guard, because this guy, it almost seems like that's a natural position for him.
Well, it is. And other guys have done a tremendous job. Right. Devon and Darius and Janiel and moved him around. But he just gives us some size out there. And he's a great passer and great leader. And I think those guys will learn a lot from him as well, and just getting a little more consistency out there at that point guard position. We only practiced it one day before we went into the Campbell game, but he did it his freshman year, and we're looking forward to doing that the rest of the season.
All righty, Coach. Let us go ahead and dive in the highlights of PC and Charleston Southern.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
We started Janiel at the point guard on Thursday here, running a little set play here to get the ball inside to Deshaun. Again, really ran a little bit too far, but we still got the ball down there inside. Did you see they're coming to fire on him? He dribbles out of the trap and again scores really two against one and an and one. The more he plays, the more he's if not the best player in the league, definitely one of the best. Again, run the play again. If it scores, we'll try to run it again. We move the ball. We got to go to a shot clock play. Austin sets an on-ball screen there for Devon. Again, Devon drives it in that gap. Great finish there by Devon. Again, we got two unbelievable young point guards in Devon Bell and Darius Moore, who are the future of this basketball team as well. A little on-ball screen there, and then step out for again, Deshaun gets hammered in another and one. You can see we're right in the game there. Again, great pass there by Deshaun, doing it all, and great three there by Reggie Dillard. Again, we played man-to-man this game. They really drove it on us, and that young man right there really my hat's off to him, had a good game. Reggie did a tremendous job on him right there. We put some size on him and kept him in front of us. Again, the great job that Reggie doing. Great pitch ahead for Janiel, and that's what we're going to get him out there doing, starting with Reggie and Will Adams, and get him out there in that open floor looking to drive it and finish. Again, Will Adams right there. Again, Devon at the point, setting up a set play. Again, looking inside there, try to run a little lob play. We got to turn around the other way. Austin needs to face the other way on that lob. You can't lob the ball in the middle of the floor. You got to lob it to the baseline side. Great pull-up jump shot there by Will Adams, who can also shoot the three as well. You can see we're down 12 or down 14 points. Again, we never could stop them, defensively. Again, and there's the lob play right there we're looking for. Great pass by Jaron and great finish by Austin. But again, just need to do that a little bit more. But again, had a very difficult time stopping in our man-to-man, especially the guy there with the ball. He had a really nice game, and so did Howard down there for us inside and really owed her help. And that's going to be real important in your man-to-man. Pretty good man-to-man here guarding the ball by Austin. Great contest and building the wall. Great block out there by Deshaun. Again, pushing the ball. We'd like to go a little faster. We need running the floor to the rim. Again, Austin down to go to an on-ball screen. Great skip pass and great three-point shot there. Great skip pass by Jaron. And great three there. Again, we got to be below nine there, but we just could never stop him in that man-to-man defense.
Well, Coach, the Buck Dome, it's a tough place to play. There's no doubt about that. But you've changed from the zone to the man-to-man. You had success with Gardner Webb. And I guess sometimes we feel like, well, if we've had so much success, let us continue with what we did coming off that.
Well, and especially it starts with me, as I'm really kind of a man-to-man guy. Our zone even better have man-to-man
right.
principles in it.
Exactly.
But I kind of got a little high after that Gardner Webb showing loved to play man-to-man and felt like we could play man-to-man, but we had some really, bad matchups. And if you're going to play man-to-man, you can't have any mistakes with your matchups. Kind of got us in foul trouble, got us in back on our heels. But we should have played them a lot more zone to stop Potter's driving and stay out of foul trouble and do a better job on Howard. But kind of throwing that game out in terms of that wasn't – we were improving every game but didn't improve that game because of our, being in that man-to-man. And we need to play them zone, and hopefully we'll get another chance there in the tournament. And I can tell you right ahead, we're going to play them zone to start out the game.
We're going to have a visit with a special senior, Janiel Jenkins. He's going to come and visit with us after the timeout as you hear a word from Presbyterian College. Give us your thoughts about your senior, Janiel Jenkins.
Well, it's absolutely awesome in terms of, what the program is about and what he's about. And then I'm glad we did give him that chance, as his grandmother called and said she was praying about giving him one more chance. And that got me. And we gave him that chance and told him, you better have a great attitude, you better be a hard worker, and you better, making no excuses and no blaming and the whole thing. And I said, the first time you have a bad attitude or excuse make or blame, you're not going to, be here long. And man, what a blessing, as he said that he was, is the guy is tough. He's mentally tough. He's physically tough. He's the hardest worker on the team. And he earned that scholarship just because he's a hard worker and his loyalty and everything. And taking, this is a guy that's been in and out of the starting lineup at times. He's not even played at times. And yet he comes into practice every day. All right. Mm-hmm. He doesn't in your office saying, why am I not here? Why am I, how did I go from starting to not playing at all? Mm-hmm. But just perseverance. And you talk about unbelievable respect. That's what I have for him, because the guy is a no excuse guy, and he just goes to work and he'll do whatever we ask, and that's awesome.
Well, and that's what it's all about too. Janiel Jenkins will be sitting in coach's chair after this word from Presbyterian College. Presbyterian College, a very special place to many people. It can be a special place for you as well. Come visit the campus right here, Presbyterian College. This young man did as well, as we bring our only senior of the basketball team this year, Janiel Jenkins. And Janiel, glad to have you here with
us
on the show. Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Well, let's dive right in and talk about Presbyterian College, what this institution has meant to you.
This institute was great to me. One word I'd say is a blessing. Mm-hmm. Being here, got great education, learned a lot from Coach Nibert. And I'm blessed with him giving me the opportunity to be here. It's a lifetime experience. I just learned a lot. It's grateful.
We're going to talk a lot about your basketball career here, but the bonds that you make with a team are one thing, but getting that Presbyterian College education and that degree, that's going to serve you for the rest of your life. I don't think anything could be bigger than that.
Yes, sir. You're correct, sir. And that take you a long way, like you said. And I'm glad I came here to finish out my 2 years of college. So that's a blessing, like I said.
Now tell us, what is your major and what do you look to do after you graduate here from Presbyterian College?
My major is political science, and I got my business minor also. So, thinking about, I really haven't decided yet what I really want to do. I'm just still, thinking about it as the closing coming to an end, so.
Now, are you going to spend your first part of your tenure after college here? Are you going back home to the greater Jacksonville area? Where are we going to find Janiel Jenkins after graduation? And are you going to be running for city council or local school boards or something like that when you get there?
I'll probably be probably back in Florida for a little bit, and probably go a little out west to out there a little bit. So wherever I find my spot at, that's what I know it'll be the right way. I don't know. Just
and when you're ready to run for office, teammates can help you. Absolutely. Let's dive into basketball now. Okay, you transferred here to Presbyterian College. Your grandmother, very influential in your life, was in Gregg Nibert's ear. Not talking about scholarships, we'll get to that in a moment, but coach, can you allow Janille to try to walk on the team? Can he try out? Tell us a little bit about that relationship between you and your grandmother and Coach Nibert.
That was a crazy story. Well,
but it's a good story.
Yes, sir. Well, my family got a lot of belief in me. They know I put a lot of work in this game, and you know I'm a hardworking kid. So they said, you know, Coach Nibert, you know, he was trying to give you this opportunity. So I'm like, all I just wanted is an opportunity. So that was that word. When I heard opportunity, he could give me, that was a blessing right there. We just told Coach, I was like, all I just need an opportunity to be here.
That's right.
I'm not looking for nothing. I just come here just to work hard and do the best I can do. You know, I want to win. So he gave it to me, and I'm here now, you know.
Well, and then last year, and I've known Gregg Nibert for quite a few years, and
yes,
I can tell you that one of his proudest moments was giving you not only the opportunity to walk on the team, but last year you earned the full scholarship. That was a proud moment for him. I'm sure a proud moment for you and a proud moment for your grandmother. Talk about that experience.
Oh, it was great. You know, got a big win over Liberty coming to the locker room.
Right. That's right.
And he just told me, he's like, you got that scholarship. When I heard that go through my ear, I was so happy, man. I was just, I know it was a blessing to me. And I just want to thank Coach Nibert for giving me the opportunity, you know, and come here and just work for that scholarship. You know, it just, I know, like, one thing about Coach Nibert, he always preached about being tough and, you know, hard work, no excuses. Them things right there make you be successful in this world. And I really like that for him. You know, so I just learned a lot from that coach, you know.
All right, Janille, we still have a lot of basketball to play as we wind down our regular season. We're looking forward to the conference tournament. You're now playing more minutes in the backcourt, handling the ball as well. A lot of good speed on the court, defending guys. We look forward to you to close out your career with a big-time bang here at Presbyterian College. Thank you so much for joining us, and we think that you're a wonderful ambassador of this institution. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Nice to be here. Thank you.
Now let's go ahead and take a timeout. When we come back, the coach, Gregg Nibert, will rejoin us right here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Bojangles, It's Bow Time. And by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Half lemonade, half ice cream, frosted lemonade, starting at 240 calories.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. During the tease, we told you that somebody was going to emerge as the new point guard. And boy, I like this move. Reggie Dillard handling the point, and he seems like a natural.
Well, he is, and he did it his freshman year, and like I said, we he's got the ball in his hands, and it's kind of like a Peyton Manning or Tom Brady. Is he can, you know, he can shoot the ball, he can shoot the three, he can take guys off the dribble, and he really can pass. So, you know, that's what you want. You got to have a guy that is triple threat out there, and that's what he does. And we're excited. We think we got our. We finally. It's hard to believe in February, 20th here, that we really feel good about who's starting, who's coming off the bench, and guys in roles, and that's what you want to do. It's kind of like a chess match all season long. You got to get your best players starting in the chemistry, and you got to get the best guys coming off the bench, and we really feel like we've got the lineup. We're going to stick with it here the rest of the season, and obviously going into that tournament, we're very excited.
Absolutely. You know, you use these last few regular season games to set up what you want to take to the tournament. So it's kind of an experimental time for the Blue Hose these last couple of games leading into the tournament. Well, Campbell, a team that PC defeated early in the year, came in to the Templeton Center, and they were hungry. They shot the ball well. Let's go ahead and take a look at the highlights. The Camels and the Blue Hose of PC.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Well, we got the tap there. Great jump by Deshaun. We ended up starting a different lineup, even though we had only one day to prepare with Reggie, and that was a good move. But put Jaron out there at the top of the zone, and he's kind of in a new position. We started Ruben to get a little scoring maybe down there inside, trying to run the play there for Deshaun. Good drive there by Jaron. Really, the first half, we shot, I think,
really
60
well.
And 50%, yeah. But we just let them have, right before half, they really lit us up. And again, really excited about that move right there. Again, Reggie passing the ball to Will Adams and draining the three. Again, inbounds play right there. Deshaun driving it. They're in a matchup zone, which is exactly like man-to-man, but he was 9 for 10. Again, got in foul trouble. Again, and great contest there by Ruben. Good block out there. Need to keep our block out a little bit better. We come up with that loose ball hitting Reggie. Again, great shot fake and pull-up jump shot by Will Adams. I'm just so proud of Will on how he's scoring the ball and shooting. Still need to fly around defensively in there. You can see Janiel's in there now. Again, they really run, as you can tell, a five-out offense against the zone because they've really got great three-point shooters. Again, make a miss. Like to outlet that ball to Daniil, but Will brings it up. Get it to him a little earlier. We now get into a set play. Again, ball fake, run him off a screen. Need to throw that ball back faster, you know. Great skip pass by Jaron. Again, flash up top there. And again, great take there, one-on-one move right there, and another and one for, again, what I think is the best player in the league.
Hard to defend.
Nine out of 10 in 22 minutes he was. Again, we got a little soft press going up there to get him to take a little time. As you can see, it's 10 to 10 in the first 5 minutes of the game. We're scoring. We don't want that was the one thing we've really got to work on is that ball getting in the high post. You don't want it to get in the high post. We got to do a better job from here on out keeping it out there. Again, now he takes it right in there again, drives the ball to the basket, and see we're scoring, but we're not stopping them. What's amazing in this first half, I think you'll see it here, is again, we're posting up and we got an overload play, but again, Austin's facing the wrong way and he can't throw the lob to the middle of the floor, and he was open. Great drive here by, I don't know how in the world he got that basket, but again, Janiel finishing around the basket, which he can. As again, you can see it's 27 all, and again, now it's 27 all. We're right in the game, but we're not stopping them. We're not stopping them. I think with 3 minutes to go, it's a tie game or down one. Again, we hit right in there, but they hit three threes right before half, which really cost us, and then we end up going man-to-man, which I'll take responsibility for that, and then they blew it. They really run a good man-to-man offensive team and blow it out there, but we got to stick to that zone, no doubt about it.
Still like Reggie Dillard, and PC did shoot the ball well. That was good to see. Now let's go ahead and transition to our offensive play of the week, brought to you by Swain Brown & Associates and Upstate Insurance Consultants.
They're pressing us, and we got our press offense set. when they have a guy with the ball, we're really looking to kind of go long a little
there
bit. And a great pass there by Jaron, and obviously great finish there by Deshaun, and just setting that up was awesome there by Jaron and Deshaun.
Well, Coach, I agree with you. If he's not the best in the league, he's definitely in the top two, Deshaun Murray. Now let's go ahead and transition to our defensive play of the week, each and every week, brought to you by Steve Crow, and that is Foothills Motorsports.
Well, we're picking up there at kind of a one-man press there with Janiel Jenkins, getting him to take as much time as they can across half court. You see the shot clock's already at 22. We're in the zone there. Again, the ball's getting down there. Great trap there by Ed and Austin and even Reggie. Great help there by Reggie Dillard. Again, unbelievable defense. Even in the zone, it's man-to-man principles. Guarding the ball there by Will. Again, great job in there. Don't quite get the steal, but unbelievable shot clock violation right there. And it almost looked like man-to-man, but great team defense by everybody in there.
In fact, two shot clock violations, Campbell, during that contest. Now let us transition to our hustle play of the game. And that's brought to you by Dan Nunnery, who was an assistant coach and also played here at Presbyterian College.
Well, we got the hustle play here of the week, which is really neat. We're down, but we need to play hard. And again, we go back to the zone, which we should have stayed in the zone the first 5 or 6 minutes of the half. They kind of blew it out there, hitting some shots, because they really are very good. I have to hand it to them, very good in their man-to-man offense. But again, we go back to the zone. As you can see, the zone is, you know, making them take some time. We got to hustle around there. We got to take that pass a little quicker. Good job there by Ruben. Good job there by Will. Back there to Ruben. Don't want him really driving the middle here. But great help in there by Austin. And again, another shot clock violation, which again, we need to stick to that zone.
There's the second one.
Yep.
Let's go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the health of the Blue Hose and our Bear Transport look ahead.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
Mike, don't look now, but Dale Earnhardt Jr. is right behind you. And Bojangles? Tim, Dale Jr. is right behind you.
I bet he is. Let me guess. He's getting a Diet Mountain Dew, and I bet he's got a two-piece dinner combo and Cajun Pintos.
Dirty rice, Tim. I got the dirty rice.
Head to Bojangles for a two-piece dinner combo with a Diet Mountain Dew. Bojangles.
It's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Well, once again, let us take a look at the health of the Blue Hose, our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, and I'll do it each and every week. Knock on wood, Blue Hose continue to be healthy.
Right? Yeah, we're blessed, Eric, and that's a big time of the year. We can't have any major injuries, and it's been really good, and hopefully it's going to last throughout the whole season.
All righty, Coach. Now let us take a look at our Bear Transport look ahead.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs.
All right, Coach, you've been experimenting. The conference is winding down, getting ready for that conference tournament, but we have Liberty that we face Saturday.
Well, we do, and again, they're still one of the hottest teams in the league. Mm-hmm. I think they're up all the way up to second or third place, and we lost 65-61 here, and we're 15 for 24 from the free throw line, so we're excited about going up there. We just want to make sure we keep getting better and better, you know, in that zone, and really feel good about Reggie being at the point and who we got starting and who we've got coming off the bench, and the guy's got a tremendous attitude and energy, and we just got to keep it up.
Absolutely, and again, it's all about the tournament, so stay tuned to GoBlueHose.com. That'll give you all the information you need as PC gets ready to enter the tournament. Well, Gregg, thank you very much for joining us once again, and this reminder, till we see you next time, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by
Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone and Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College. We would like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors. The Bud Group. Good Times Entertainment. Carolina Concrete. Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Midway Barbecue. Hanna Heating and Air Conditioning. Epting Turf and Tractor. Arthur State Bank. Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton. Wilson's Cafe. Tony's Pizza, and Steamer's Cafe.